It is not the best of times for the All Progressives Grand Alliance, APGA, as a party battle for the leadership and the problems that are being faced. And then our debate over who will fly the flag of the party ahead of the November 6th governorship election in Anambra State. And that contest intensifies now. A high court presided over by Justice Chukwu the Orca had ordered INEC to enlist Soludo, Professor Charles Soludo, as the candidate of APGA and drop Chukwu the Omeoji, earlier published by INEC. Justice Oka said Dr. Victor Oye is the authentic national chairman of APGA and had the right to conduct primary election of the party and produce or sponsor a candidate of the party in the poll and not the Jude Okeke faction of the party. But the contest over that continues. Let's get to hear from the two sides of the divide tonight. I'm being joined by virtually by Sly Eze Okenwa. He's a National League Advisor of APGA. He is of the Victor Oye faction. And Ikechukwu Chukwunyere is the National Publicity Secretary of the Jude Okeke faction. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for coming on tonight. Let me begin Mr. Chukwunyere, because that court judgment said that Victor Oye should be recognized as the party national chairman, and Professor Soludo should be enlisted as the governorship candidate of APGA. What's your side's reaction to that?
Good evening, Nigerians, once again. It is important that we understand where we are coming from, so that we can now know where we are going to. On April 17, 2019, the then leadership of APGA, led by Victor Oye, had communicated to the National Office of INEC of their intention to organize the world local government and state congresses on the 2nd, 3rd, and 6th of May 2019, while the convention was scheduled to hold on the 31st May 2019 at Owerri. Now, on the 10th of May 2019, the National Secretariat, having received the report of the congresses conducted at the World Local Government and State, discovered that if they are to go into the convention with the list of delegates they have so far, automatically a Victor Oye will not be returned as a national chairman. So on the 14th of May, Oye had communicated to a call for a purported National Executive Committee meeting, excluding the BOT members of the party. Now, at this so-called 14th May 2019 meeting, the Oye and his friends decided to dissolve the BOT of the party. They also decided to dissolve the congresses already conducted on the 2nd, 3rd, and 6th of May 2019. And they now decided to reschedule the congresses for 19th, 20th, and 21st. Now we should bear in mind, okay, they also decided to also shift the convention that already was stated for Owerri to Oka. And we must bear in mind that there was a suit by one Olalere at where Justice Masoud A.A. Abbas gave a judgment that congresses must hold on the 2nd, 3rd, and 2nd, 3rd, and 6th. Now, Oye defiled this judgment of the Oyo State High Court. Again, the BOTs that were excluded at the meeting on the 14th also went to a court in Kwale, where they obtained an ex parte order stopping Oye and order from acting on any decision emanating from the purported MEC meeting. So, of course, the 31st meeting, the 31st convention held as scheduled in Owerri, and Chidozie Njoku emerged as the national chairman of the party.
You've laid the premise. You've laid the premise, but I'm trying to get your direct response to the latest judgment, saying that Victor Oye is a national chairman.
No, there is a judgment from Jigawa State by His Lordship Honorable Justice Musa Obale, where in suit number JDU 022-2021, on the 22nd of June 2021, where a judgment was given that the authentic acting national chairman of the party is High Chief Duke Okeke. And on that basis, the INEC was decided to recognize Honorable Tukuma Umwaje as the authentic candidate of the party in the governorship election.
All right. So let me bring in Sly Ezekiel Nwaku to respond to what you said. Sly, you heard what Mr. Chukwuemeka has explained, and the premise is laid, which is that there is an existing judgment. How do you react to what he said?
Yes, thank you very much, Shehu. I hope you can hear me.
Absolutely. Please go ahead, loud and clear.
Now, I always make a point. Very clear point. When a lawyer is talking, you rely on documents. You don't come and tell us your knowledge or what you think or your opinion. If you say that APGA under Chief Victor Oye notified INEC on the 17th of April for congresses to be held on the 2nd, 3rd, and 6th, you produce the document. You don't come and tell us that the party gave notices for congresses to be held on certain days from, I don't know where he got that information. Now, what I have here, if you look at this document, this is the report of INEC for APGA congresses and the National Convention. Now, if you go inside this document, the first notice that APGA gave INEC for congresses stated clearly that the World Congresses were to be held on the 22nd. Clearly, this is a certified true copy of the monitoring report from INEC. So you don't just come and just start making unnecessary insinuations and assumptions or bogus claims without any documents to back you up. Now, with respect to what he said, I can bet you that Mr. Ikechukwu Chukwuemeka doesn't even know the date the judgment he's referring to in Ibadan was delivered. The judgment of Honorable Justice Abbas was delivered on the 28th day of May. Now, one of their bogus claims is the fact that they conducted congresses in obedience to that judgment. Can you imagine that manner of fallacy? You were obeying a judgment that was not yet in existence. I can bet you he has not even seen the judgment. Now, coming back to the argument he made with respect to the judgment of Honorable Justice Musa Obane, I can tell you, and I always make that point clearly, that judgment has no business whatsoever to do with Chief Dr. Victor Ikeoye. If you read that judgment, it is very clear. The court purported to have removed Chief Edozie Njoku, and in his place appointed Chief Jude Okeke as the acting national chairman of their faction. That is what the court did. And the law, I always make that point. If your principal has a defective title, you cannot acquire a better title than the man you're stepping into his shoes. So what the court did, as far as we are concerned, if you read that judgment, it is clear that the judgment was a nullity. Why do I say that it's a nullity? Prior to that judgment, there was an earlier judgment of Oka High Court delivered on the 18th day of November 2020. This is the judgment. So when you make reference, you tell him whenever he makes reference, let him present a document. This is a certified true copy of the judgment of Oka High Court.
So I made a reference to the latest judgment.
Yes.
Because for you politicians,
okay,
it might be straightforward. But for my viewers who just want to get the meat of the story, all these court judgments and court cases are a bit confusing for them. So the court said that that INEC should enlist Professor Charles Soludo and validate Victor Oye as the national chairman of the party.
Exactly.
So has INEC done that?
We have duly submitted that judgment to INEC. And we expect that INEC, when they do have their next meeting, they are going to fully comply with that judgment. I will tell you why that judgment is instructive. This particular matter that I'm referring to
matters.
That was delivered, this judgment that was delivered by the High Court of Awka, validated the National Convention of APGA. Now, the latest judgment of the court, which was delivered on the 19th day of July, is instructive for one thing. For the very first time, we have a judgment that determined the right of both factions. I want to clearly use that word, faction. That judgment delivered on the 19th, because the parties in that matter are, I was the first plaintiff, and then APGA was the second plaintiff. And we sued on behalf of the National Working Committee of APGA that were elected at the National Convention of APGA held in Awka on the 31st day of May 2019. And I sued Chief Judo, Chief Edozie Njoku, for himself and all those purported to have been elected alongside with him at the purported convention that was supposed to have taken, or that was purported to have taken place in Owerri. For the very first time, we had a judgment that evaluated the right of both sides, took the facts with respect to everything concerning the judgment. I can tell you, up till now, let Ikechukwu Chukwunye present a document where APGA gave INEC notice that it will hold convention in Owerri.
So, I mean, the implication of the leadership tussle in your party is far-reaching. I said that because it directly impacts on your preparation as a party towards the Anambra governorship election and your ability to present one candidate, because at the end of the day, APGA, we have one candidate on the ballot. So let me bring in back Mr. Chukwunyere into the conversation. So I will go to your party and the governorship election and the candidacy, the kind of candidate that you will present forward. Is it a dilemma for your faction now after this judgment? Or where do you go from here? They said they've presented the judgment to INEC. That means INEC will have to act to prove Professor Chukwu Masoludo on the list of the candidate for the election.
Okay. Thank you very much. Sly, yes, okay, Mama. It is important that we also clear some things he has stated here. First and foremost, Oye had gone to court in Abuja FCT/HC/CV/2086/2019 between Victor Oye and APGA and Edozie Njoku, wherein he sought and was granted interlocutory order of injunction restraining the second defendant, Edozie Njoku, from further parading himself as the national chairman of the, and then also restraining APGA from recognizing Edozie Njoku as the national chairman. However, upon receiving the statement of defense of Chief Edozie Njoku, Oye fled and filed a notice of discontinuance in the suit. While pronouncing on the notice of continuance, Justice OC Abaza, the presiding judge, ordered that all orders granted in the suit were vacated and accordingly struck out the suit, which automatically meant that Edozie Njoku remained the national chairman of the party as at then. Now, coming to the judgment of Justice Awka, we all know Justice Awka and his relationship with Oye. Have Nigerians wondered why all APGA cases are decided by Justice Awka? Is Justice Awka the only judge in Anambra State? Are we not aware that this same justice has there are several petitions on this justice? Now, on the matter of who is the authentic or who will fly the ticket of the party in the 2021 governorship election, it is not debatable. INEC has recognized Umoji, Honorable Chukwu Umoji, as the authentic candidate of the party. Now, Honorable Chukwu Umoji is a two-time member. Honorable Chukwu Umoji is a former local government chairman. This is a man that has a lot of experience. This man is a neophyte in the administration.
All right.
So a man that has tested the legislature and also tested the executive.
Okay.
He's not that going to be a wonderful governor.
Let me get you've laid that point. So, but I will allow Sly Ezekiel to give his final thought. I'll take that as your final thought. Sly
Ezekiel,
let me get your own final thought, because we need to close in a minute or so.
Yeah, Sheung, I can tell you one thing. He has made heavy weather of Honorable Umoji being on the INEC list. And to answer that question, I will draw an analogy. Incidentally, I am an Arsenal fan, and then there is this joke that is normally told about Arsenal. And it's very simple. When you see, they say when you see Arsenal on top of the Premier League table, it's like seeing an elephant on a tree. You can't tell how it got there, but you can be sure it will fall off that tree. So there is no issue whatsoever with regards to who the candidate of APGA is. INEC, if you look at the list of INEC, the list released by INEC, you will see beside Honorable Umoji's name, the words, court order. It shows that this was not the candidate nominated by APGA. Haji Jude Okeke never got the call to upload candidate from INEC.
All right.
INEC doesn't know who he is.
Gentlemen, we've got to go, but I must sincerely thank both of you. Mr. Chukwuyere and Mr. Ezekiel, apologies, we are out of time. We may do this some other time, but we are totally out of time. Thank you so much, gentlemen.